Burnley Film Makers' 43rd Annual Film Festival took place on Sunday the 17th of March at Burnley Youth Theatre. As the guests arrived, Mark and Jeff from Burnley Film Makers were busy in the control room. Mike Breeze, chairman of Burnley Filmmakers, opened the festival.
Good afternoon, everybody. Very pleased to see you all here this afternoon, in spite of the weather, the wind. We've got good attendance this afternoon. It's great. I'd like to thank Bradford for their support, because they have got more members than anybody else here. You've got your programme, ladies and gentlemen. It'll be as per the schedule. And I do hope that you'll enjoy this afternoon. Thank you very much.
It's been a static exhibit at the National Railway Museum, York, for many years. She is one of 9 surviving engines of this class.
And it is a tremendous thing that steam locomotive should be built.
Lighthouse was a short stub of the structure. Here you can see the various rings of stone laid out on the shoreline in the order in which they were removed. On the last ring you can...
The R&IB target watch works exactly the same way as a normal wristwatch. However, this watch reads out the current date and time. For example,
today is Sunday, January 6th.
Good company, I think. We're from quite different walks of life. I mean, we all obviously have the means to go on adventurous trips, but we're not all the same. But we all have the essential things in common. We enjoy each other's company, both in and out of the water.
A town of 15,000 people, 34 miles northwest of Manchester, and situated in the beautiful Ribble Valley, is a very desirable place to live. It is dominated by Pendle Hill and rolling countryside, and has a good road and railway system to Preston, Skipton, Blackburn, Norburn Castle, and an adjacent modern museum, both of which are surrounded by a field in which band concerts...
Remember the sign. Trust me, I've led you to this special day. I'll deliver you to the great uplifting very soon. We have all waited so long. Now we can be rewarded. It's going to be so great. We're going to be uplifted to another world. We might get superpowers. Norman, you haven't been listening.
Don't be stupid, Norman. We don't know.
Look. That not so long ago could be found in every corner of the United Kingdom, was housed in a purpose-built kiosk, commonly called the Red Telephone Box. These small buildings, made from cast iron and glass, resembled miniature temples. They were part of the landscape of Britain. However, most have gone.
Celebrated rock scene builders Pullum and Son, and recommended that they be employed to create Cleveland's vision, the Ravine, an incredible feat of engineering at the time. at risk, having been neglected and overgrown for almost 100 years. I was commissioned to carry out a stage one assessment of the rock work, and after my recommendations for selected vegetation removal, we are now able to explore the characteristics and condition of the rock scenery, including the traditional Pullum trademark. As we progress upwards through the low cataracts, the scenery here becomes more animated. And here we have a traditional Pullum dropping well and cavernous recess, quite dramatic.
Adopted the manner of judging that they use in BAF. In our case, we watched your DVDs on a Sony 49-inch TV, playing the DVDs on a Sony Blu-ray player, and with the sound coming out of a Canton soundbar. Very difficult to judge, as always, and as I said at the beginning, if just one of us had been the judge, the awards would have been different. I think every award was a majority rather than a unanimous decision. I've booked to go to BAF in Birmingham in April, so if any of you are there, please do come up, tell me that we got it all wrong, and then buy me a drink. Bye for now.
Well done to all those taking part this year, and we'll see you again in 2020.